This video will explain the structure of urethra. Urethra is a tube. It connects urinary bladder to urinary meatus. It is for the removal of urine from the body of both females and males. About its structure, it is a fibrous and muscular tube. It connects urinary bladder to external urethral meatus. It differs between the sexes. First, about male urethra. It is average 18 to 20 cm in length in males. It opens at the end of external urethral meatus. The male urethra is divided into four parts: pre-prostatic, prostatic, membranous, and penile. This table explains the characteristics of four regions of male urethra. First, about pre-prostatic urethra. It is the intramural part, for it lies within the bladder. Its length varies between 0.5 to 1.5 cm depending on the fullness of bladder. It is lined by transitional epithelium. The second is prostatic urethra. It crosses through the prostate gland, so it is that name. It has several openings. The first one, the ejaculatory duct. Second, the prostatic duct. Third, prostatic utricles. These openings are collectively called vermontanum. It is lined by transitional epithelium. The third part is membranous urethra. It is about 1 to 2 cm in length. It is within external urethral sphincter. The bulbar urethra glands, also called the corpus glands, are found posterior to this region. The fourth and the last part is spongy urethra. It is also called a penile urethra. It runs along the length of penis on its ventral surface. It is about 15 to 25 cm in diameter. The duct from urethra gland, otherwise called a gland of litter, and the openings of bulbar urethra glands are found here. Sometimes, or some textbook divide this urethra into two parts, bulbous and pendulous urethra. The urethral lumen runs effectively parallel to the penis, except at its narrowest point near to the external urethral meatus, where it is vertical. Throughout the penile length, the urethra is parallel to penis, but near to external urethral meatus, it is vertical. It creates a spiral stream of urine, and it has an effect on cleaning the external urethral meatus. So this mechanism is absent in female urethra. It partly explains why urinary tract infections are more common in females. It is lined by pseudocolumnar epithelium in the proximal portion and stratified squamous epithelium in the distal portion. This picture you can see the four parts of urethra: pre-prostatic urethra, prostatic urethra within the prostate, and membranous urethra surrounded by external urethral sphincter, and posterior to it there is bulbo urethral gland. The duct of bulbo urethral gland opens into spongy urethra. Spongy urethra has two bend. First bend here in the beginning, and the second bend at the beginning of penile shaft. It opens into external urethral orifice. In this image, you can see a little more clearly the different part. This is the external urethral orifice. This is the penis, and this within which the penis, penile urethra lie or spongy urethra lie. Here you can see the membranous urethra surrounded by external urethral sphincter. On either side, you can see bulbo urethral gland. That is the membranous urethra. Then above which we can see prostatic urethra surrounded by prostatic gland, and within the internal urethral sphincter there is pre-prostatic urethra. About neurovascular supply and lymphatic drainage. Three regions of urethra have different arterial, nerve, and lymphatic supply. The arterial supply of prostatic urethra, inferior vesical artery; membranous urethra, bulbo urethral artery; penile urethra, branches of internal pudendal artery. Nerve supply is from prostatic plexus. Lymphatic drainage also vary according to the region of urethra. The prostate and the membranous portion drain into obturator and internal lymph nodes. The penile urethra drain into deep superficial inguinal nodes. About the structure of female urethra. The length is about 4 cm. It begins at the neck of the bladder. It passes inferiorly through the pelvic floor muscles. It opens directly into the perineum in an area called vestibule. Thus, it extends from internal urethral orifice to external urethral orifice. Within the vestibule, anteriorly we can see vaginal opening and posteriorly we can see clitoris. The distal urethra is marked by presence of two mucous glands. They are called as Skene's glands. The proximal two-thirds is lined by transitional epithelium. The distal one-third is lined by stratified squamous epithelium. Between the superior and inferior fascia of urogenital septum, the female urethra is surrounded by urethral sphincter. This is the opening of female urethra, external urethral orifice. This is the vestibule where the urethra opens. Posteriorly, we can see clitoris, anteriorly, we can see vagina. This is the vaginal orifice. On either side of the vagina, we can see Bartholin's gland. Here you can see external urethral orifice, which is surrounded by external urethral sphincter on either side of urogenital septum. On either side of urogenital septum, the external urethral sphincter lies and surrounds female urethra in its distal one-third. It starts from bladder neck, where it is surrounded by internal urethral sphincter. This image shows the cross section of female urethra, the different layers of the wall. It has a lumen. The lumen is surrounded by mucosa or epithelial lining, where it is transitional and pseudo stratified. Then below that we can see submucosa. Then after that we can see the muscularis layer, where there is inner longitudinal muscle and outer circular muscle, and outermost we can see tunica serosa or tunica adventitia. About its neurovascular and lymphatic drainage. The arterial supply is via internal pudendal artery, vaginal artery and inferior vesical artery. The venous drainage is given the same names as that of arteries. The nerve supply arises from vesical plexus and a pudendal nerve. The lymphatic drainage of proximal female urethra is into internal lymph nodes and the distal part is into superficial inguinal lymph nodes. About the general microanatomy of both urethra in males and females. It lines epithelium, or it is lined by epithelium. It starts as the transition epithelium. Here you can see in this picture, this is the male urethra. The first two portions are prostatic and membranous urethra. They are lined by transitional epithelium. They are called transitional because they are able to change their shape. The cells are able to change their shape from flat to cuboidal depending on whether they are compressed by contents of urethra. Then after that, the urethra are lined by pseudo-stratified columnar and a squamous epithelium in its distal, proximal and distal portion. In the beginning, transition epithelium. After that, pseudo-stratified columnar epithelium, then squamous epithelium. Then, in general, the urethra has four layers with a little difference that we have seen already. The first layer is, or the innermost layer is tunica mucosa, which consists of epithelium. We have seen the epithelial characteristics of urethra. Then, tunica submucosa, it has the cavernous tissue space that are typical of erectile tissue in males. Then third layer is tunica muscularis, female muscularis layer we have seen already. In males, there is inner and outer longitudinal layer and middle smooth muscle layer as in bladder. But towards the external urethral orifice, it has striated urethralis muscle. And the final layer or the outermost layer is tunica serosa or tunica adventitia. This is the lumen. Near to lumen, there is mucosa lined by epithelium, then the submucosa layer, then the muscle layer, then the adventitia layer or serosa layer. About the clinical conditions of urethra, first hypospadia and epispadia. We have seen normally the meatus is located at the distal end of penis. When the meatus is different in its location, then it is called a hypospadia, where the location is on the under surface of the penis. Means the meatus opens and in the under surface of the penis. When the meatus is seen on the dorsal surface of the penis, that is called a epispadia. Hypo means below or in the under surface. Epi means above or in the dorsal surface. Then the second condition is urethritis, that is infection of urethra. Third, cancer of urethra. Then there are some procedures which are done through urethra. One is called a cystoscopy, that means the endoscopy study of blood done through urethra. It is called a cystoscopy. Then urine cytology, that is examination of urine specimen for abnormal cellular characteristics. Then urinary catheterization, which is a procedure where a catheter is inserted into the bladder through the urethra to drain it. Then male catheterization is difficult compared to female catheterization because of the tube bend that we have already seen in a picture. This is all about structure of urethra in male and female. Thank you for listening. Please subscribe and share.